Hello my dear students, welcome for today's video lecture of maths. Today we are going to start the next chapter, that is chapter number 8, decimal. Before that, see, in chapter fraction we had taken some extra concepts from the outside book, the concept which are not in our textbook, extra, okay. So I have got some doubts that some students are not able to understand that because it is not given in the textbook, it is out of the textbook. So, and due to this online teaching, they are not able to understand those concepts. So, in chapter fraction, only the three practices, 7.1, 7.2 and 7.3, these three practice of concepts will be asked for the exam, okay. The extra concept which we have taken, comparing fraction and equivalent fraction, those two concepts will not be asked, okay. So now see, the next chapter we are going to start, that is decimal, okay. See, when you go, have you gone to the petrol pump ever to fill the petrol in your car or motorcycle with your parents? Yes. So on that petrol pump, you might have seen the price of petrol written on that petrol, where the petrol is filled, right? So the price of petrol is written in this way, 91.65, or price of diesel 75.50, correct? Also, you know your weight, when you measure your weight, it is showing like this, 30.5 kg, right? Your rupees. So see here, if you observe these numbers, have we learned like these numbers in our number system, Indian number system or international number system? Have we learned about this? No. 91.65, 75.50 or 30.5 kg. So these numbers in which there is this point, these numbers are called decimal numbers. These numbers are called decimal numbers, and this point is there, no? It is called decimal point. Decimal point. Okay. So the numbers in which there is decimal point, they are called decimal numbers. So see here, decimal numbers are not different. Decimal numbers are one kind of fraction. The fraction which we have learned before, the decimal kind of numbers are one of the form of fraction. We have seen fraction 4 upon 7, 9 upon 15, 13 upon 18, okay, like these fractions we have seen, like these many fractions we have seen, okay, having numerator and denominator, okay. So in this, among these fractions, there are some fractions whose denominators are 10 or 100 or 1000 or 10,000, 1 lakh. See, in these fractions, the denominator is 10, 100, 1000. Okay, 10, 100, 1000. Getting? So, this type of fraction having denominator 10, 100, 1000 and so on. These type of fractions can be written in another way. Okay? This type of fraction having the denominator 10, 100, 1000 can be written in another way. Which way? In this way. In the form of decimal numbers. Okay, so these type of fractions are also called decimal fractions. This type of fraction where denominator is fractions having numerator and denominator, they are called common fractions. They are called common fractions. Okay, but some common fractions whose denominator is 10, 100, 1000, they are also called decimal fractions, and they can be written in the form of decimal numbers. So how to write that, how to read that, okay? How to find their place values, that we are going to learn. Have you understood this? Decimal numbers means what? They are fractions, one form of fractions whose denominator is 300 and 1000 and so on. Okay. So now see here. These are the numbers 91.65, 75.50, 30.5. These are called decimal numbers. Okay. In this 91.65, see. 91.65. There are two parts. Due to this decimal point, this number is divided into two parts. This part before decimal point, and then another part after decimal point. Okay. So the part which is before decimal point, no, it is called whole number part. Whole number part. And the part which is after decimal point, it is called decimal number part. It is called decimal number part. Now see what is mean by whole. In fraction you have learned whole means what? Whole means complete one. Or complete. Whole means complete. I ate 91.65 chocolates, not within one day. I ate 91.65 chocolates means 91 complete chocolates I ate, and 0.65 means from 93rd chocolate, 92nd chocolate. 91 complete chocolates I ate, and from 90. The chocolate which was at 92nd number, from that I ate 0.65 part. Okay, 0.65 part means this is fractional part. It is a part of one whole. Okay, so this is it's called decimal number part. This is whole. 91 complete chocolates or 91 complete cakes, and from 92nd cake I ate 0.65 cake. Means not complete. That not complete 92nd. Okay. Means what? See, one second I will show you with the small number. It is suppose 2.5. Means what is meaning of this? As I told you, this is whole number part. And the part which is after decimal point, it is decimal number part. Okay. Decimal number part. So what is meaning of whole part? I said you whole means complete. Means complete two. So this there are suppose three cakes. Now and 2.5 means this first two cake I ate completely. First two cakes. And next third one cake, no, I ate 0.5 part of that. Now 0.5 means half actually. So half of that. Okay. So 2 whole means 2 whole. 0.5. 5 means half. Okay. Why 5 means half? Because 5 means 0.5. And it means 5 out of 10. So 5 out of 10 means if you divide this cake into 10 equal parts, I ate 5. And 5 is half of 10, correct? That means half cake of the third one. So 2 whole means this, and this is fractional part, that is decimal part. Okay. Understand the meaning of this, the part which is before decimal point and part which is after decimal point. Whole number part, decimal number part. Okay. Now let's learn the places. Places. You know, this is whole number part. Whole numbers means numbers start with the 0 to uncountable. They are called whole numbers. 0, 1, 2, 3. That we have learned in the Indian number system or international number system in the first chapter. Okay. And how was their place system? Or how was their places? From this side. Now this is whole number part, right? So last place was ones place, right? Then these tens, these hundreds, these thousands, correct? Ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. Similarly, what will be the name of the places after decimal point? These also places have some name. What it will be? I'll tell you. You know, this one means one, correct? Tens means 10. Multiply by number means 10. 100 means 100. And thousands means thousands, correct? Means as we move towards the left side, this side, the digit on this side is multiplied by 1 year, by 10, by 100, by 1000, okay? Similarly, when we move towards the right side, this side, the first place, immediately first place after decimal point is called 10th place. What? 10th. Here there is 10s. Here there is 10th, okay, 10th. And 10th means what? 1 upon 10. 10th means 1 upon 10, as we have seen in the fraction. If this fraction is there, 1 upon 10, how do we read that? 1/10, correct? 1/10. We have seen. So 1/10 is same as 10th, okay? After 10th, next place will be 100. What? 100. And 100 means 1 upon 100, correct? 100. Then next place will be 1000. Okay? And 1000 means 1 upon 1000 in this way. So the places of the whole numbers we have learned in the first chapter, ones, tens, hundreds, thousands. But places after decimal point, places after decimal point, you have to keep it in mind now. Immediately after decimal point, first place is called 10th. Then next place 100. And next place 1000. That means what? If you want to write the place value, place value of 3 ones means 3 multiplied by 1 plus 7 tens means 7 multiplied by 10 plus 5 hundreds means 5 multiplied by 100 plus 2 thousands place, so 2 multiplied by 1000. In this way we will write that place values, correct? Similarly, if you want to write place value of these places, decimal places, 2/10 means 2 multiplied by 1/10 and it plus 800, that means 8 multiplied by 1/100 plus 9000, that means 9 multiplied by 1/1000. So here 2 into 1000 means 2000 plus 5 into 100 means 500 plus 7 into 10 means 70 plus 3 into 1 means 3 plus 2 into 1/10 means 2 ones are 2 upon 10 2 tenth plus 8 into 1 upon 100 is 800 8 upon 100 plus 9 into 1 upon 1000 is 9 upon 1000, that is 9000. So in this way we write the place values. Understand? See, 2 upon 10, that when there is denominator 10, that means it is the first place immediately after decimal point. If the denominator is 100, it shows that it is the second place after decimal point. If the denominator is 1000, it shows that it is the third place after decimal point. Understand? 10th place, 100th place, 1000th place. These places you already know. 1, 10, 100, 1000. Just memorize these places. 10th, 100th, 1000. Okay? 10th means upon 10. 100th means upon 100. Upon means in the denominator. Okay? So this is the concept of decimal. Now, we will see how to write. As I told you, decimal numbers are one of the form of fraction only. Decimal numbers are one of the form of fractions, right? Okay, so such fractions whose denominator is 10, 100 and 1000. So let us learn how to write those common fractions into decimal numbers. Okay, see here, common fractions means what I said you, such fractions or decimal fractions means such fractions whose denominator is 10, 100 and 1000. So let us write some such fractions: 5 upon 10, 25 upon 100, 327 upon 1000, 4935 upon 1000. Okay, now these are our common fractions with the denominator 10, 100 and 1000. Let us learn how to convert these fractions into decimal, how to write these fractions into decimal form, the decimal point. Okay, so see, 5 upon 10, what is rule of this? See, the denominator is 10. Okay, denominator is 10, in that there is 10. That means while converting this number 5 into decimal point, after decimal point there should be one digit. Okay, as there is 10 in the 10, so whatever digits are there, now here there is only one digit, so that will come after decimal point, and before decimal point there is no any whole number, so 0. So 5 upon 10, how to write in the decimal form? 0.5. okay, similarly 25 upon 100, in 100 there are two zeros, that means 100th place will come in the second place, right? So after decimal point there should be two digits, as this is 100th, you know, 100th second place, two digits after decimal point. So are there two digits in the numerator? Yeah, so both the two digits will come after decimal point, and here 0.25. So 25 upon 100 is same as 0.25. similarly, see here, 327 upon 1000. Now in 1000 there are three zeros, so write this number here, and there are three zeros, so after decimal point we want three digits, so from back side 1, 2, 3 digits, and here 0.327. okay, here see, 4935, write this number here, 4935, and denominator is 1000, in 1000 there are three zeros, so we have to put decimal point before three digits from back side. Okay, so 1, 2, 3 here, so the number is 4.935. okay, what we have done, there was denominator 1000, so we have put decimal point before three digits. One thing I'll show you, so see here, 2957 upon 10. How to convert this into decimal? How to convert this into decimal numbers? What to do? First, the number which is in the numerator, write as it is here. Okay. Now see the denominator, it is 10, means there is 10 in the 10. So there is 10, and because of that, why put in decimal point? From right side, from back side, put the decimal point before one digit, from back side, from this side, this here the one digit, so before that put decimal point. Why before one digit? Because there is 10 in the 10. Okay, see here, 9562 upon 100, so that the number which is in the numerator, right, as it is, and see the denominator 100, there are two zeros, so where to put decimal point? From back side, before two digits, 1, 2 here. So the answer is 95.62. Along with this, we will learn how to read the fraction, how to read the fraction, decimal numbers. 0.5. So this can be read as 0.5. 0.25. How to read this? 0.25, not 25. See, we don't have to read this 0.25. No, we have to read this as a 0.25. The number which is in the decimal number part means after decimal point, it should be written as, or it should be read as 25 with the name of that digit. Okay, the number which is before decimal point, it will be read as whole numbers. It's as we read, for example, here 295.7. This will not be read as 295. No, the number which is after decimal point, it will be read as the name of the digits. So here this can be written as 295.7. In this way it can be read. Here 95.62? No, 95.62. It can be read as 95.62. Okay, so this whole number, no, it will be read as it is, as we read the regular numbers, because it is whole number, but this is the decimal number, so it will be read as the name of the digit, 62 and a point. 95.62, 295.7, 0.5, 0.25, 0.327, 4.935. Okay, so here we have learned how to write common fractions into decimal. Let us learn how to opposite. If the decimals are given, how to convert them into common fractions. Now see, these are decimal numbers, correct? 0.6, 2.78, 5.8, 29.392. These are decimal numbers. So we can write these decimal numbers, we can convert these decimal numbers into fractions. Okay, so how to convert that? We have learned how to convert common fractions into decimal, but now we are going to learn how to write decimals into common fraction having numerator and denominator. Okay, so what to do? 0.6. Okay, so 0.6, without put finger on the decimal point and see which number you are able to see. 0.6 means 06, right? So that right here, 06 means 6 only, and put 1 here in the denominator and check here after decimal point how many digit is there. 1 digit. So after 1, put 10. So 0.6 is equal to 6 upon 10. Okay. Next here also 2.78. So without considering decimal point, write that number 278 here. Bar, write 1. Then check after decimal point how many digits are there. There are 2 digits. So after 1, let's put 20. So 2.78 is equal to 278 upon 100. 5.8, without considering decimal point, write the number in the numerator, 58 upon, write 1, and see after decimal point there is 1 digit, so put 10. So 5.8 is same as 58 upon 10. 29.392, without considering decimal point, write the number 29,392 upon how many digits? 1 right here, and after decimal point there are 3 digits, so put 3 zeros after 1. Okay, so in this way we can convert decimal numbers into common fractions. We will practice more examples in our practice 8.1. Before that, pause this video and write this in your notebook.
Okay.
So let's solve practice 8.1, which is based on all these concepts of the decimal which we have learned now. Before that, let's see first quick check on page number 113. Open your page number 113. Quick check. In that, the first fill in the blank is the numeral for 1/10 is, how to write 1/10 will be 1 upon 10. Okay, so write there. Second, the numeral for dash is 0.01 is there. The numeral for 0.01 is what? Means the fraction. 001 means 1 upon, after decimal point 2 digits are there, so 100, 2 zeros, 1 upon 100. Okay? Or see, this 0.01, what we write in the spelling? 0.01. Okay? The numeral point 0.01 is 0.01. Okay? Next. The dash for 1000 is 0.001. See now, second, the numeral for dash is 0.01. The numeral for dash is 0.01. See, it will be 100. Okay? Next. The dash for 1000 is 0.001. Numeral. The numeral for, in the third type numeral, the numeral for 1000 is 0.001. Fourth one. How will you read 2.09? So, 2.09. This is the answer of fourth one. Okay. Then fifth one. Which decimal will be read as 0.35? 0.35. Okay. This decimal will be read as 0.35. Understand? So this was about quick check. Write these answers in the empty places. Let's see now practice 8.1, question number 1. Question number 1 is, read the following fractions and write them in the words. Means we have to give decimal numbers are given. I'll take some of them and remaining you have to do by yourself, so that you can see whether you have understood the concept or not. Okay? See, 0.5, means these are decimal numbers they have given and we have to write that. How can we read this? So 0.5 means 0.5, correct? Write this in the notebook. Solve this practice 8.1 in the notebook. This how to read 0.13. How to read 0.13? No, 0.13. This 0.003, correct? 0.003. This 0.17 or 0.17? 0.17. Okay, in this way we will read this. Remaining examples solve yourself. Question 2 is, see now, write the numeral representing each of the following. They have given in this way, in spelling, we have to write numeral for it. First one I am not writing here, just reading. And directly writing answer, but while When you will write in the notebook, write that question also, okay?
A one.
6.8. So it will be written as 6.8, correct?
B one.
4.02. So see, 4.02. Is it difficult?
Not at all, right?
C one. 10.5. Next, 6.84. Understood? So in this way, first write that question given in the textbook and then make dash and write this numeral for it. Understand? Pause this and write these two questions. After that, remaining example solve. Okay? See the next question. Question number 3. See question number 3. Write the following as a common fractions. They have given here decimal fractions. 0.07, 0.6, 0.002, 0.08 and so on. They have given here decimal fractions and these decimal numbers we have to convert into common fractions having numerator and denominator. Okay, so we have learned this. How to do that? Without considering decimal point, first write the number which is getting here. 007 means it will be 7 only. 007 means 7 only. Then you bar in the numerator, write 1, denominator write 1, and after 1 how many 0 to be put here, that is depend on the decimal places. Here how many decimal places are there? Decimal places means the digits after decimal point. So after decimal point how many digits are there? There are 2 digits. So put 2 zeros here. So it is 700. Okay. 0.6. Without considering decimal point, which number we are getting here? 0.6 means 6, correct? And write 1 here, and after decimal point there is 1 digit, so 10. 6 upon 10. 0.002 means 2 only upon 1 right here. After decimal point 1, 2, 3. 3 digits are there, so 1, 2, 3. 2000. Okay. 0.08 means without considering decimal point here, 008 means 8 only upon, right, 1 here, and after 1 how many digits? How many zeros? 2 zeros. Okay. 800. Remaining solve by us, you have to solve. See the next question. Question number 4. Write the following fractions as decimals. Now fractions are given. We have to convert them into decimal as we have done. We have learned while learning the concept. Okay. It is also very easy. 8 upon 10. What to do? We have to convert them into decimal numbers with the decimal point. Okay. So what to do? This numerator, no, numerator, that right here first. 8. Now we have to put decimal point. Where to put? See the denominator. Denominator is 10. Means in 10 there is 10, and that 10 tells us that we have to put decimal point before one digit from back side. Now here there is only one digit. That means the decimal point will come before this 0.8. So 0.8 means 0.8. Okay. Here 4 upon 10. First write 4 here. In 10 there is 10, so decimal point will come before one digit, that is before 4, so 0.4. 6 upon 100. Now see here, the number in the numerator right here 6. Now see the denominator 100. 100 has 2 zeros, and those 2 zeros tells us that we have to put decimal point before 2 digits, but here there is only 1 digit. So where to put, where are the 2 digits? We have to put decimal point before two digits. But here there is only one digit, so what we have to do, you know, one and second digit is not there, so here we will write 0, 1, 0 and here decimal point, and here 0. So 0.06, getting? 0.06 further can be written as 6 upon 100, understand? 12 upon 100, 12 in the number in the numerator right here. And in 100 there are 2 zeros, so decimal point will come before 2 digits. So there are 2 digits, 1, 2. So decimal point will come here, okay? So in this way, complete the remaining examples. See, last one question. In a math test, this I am going to pause this video, write in your notebook. Question number 5. In a math test of 100 marks, a student secured 3/4 of total marks. Express his marks as a decimal. Okay. Now see, total marks are 100. And that student got 3/4 marks, 3 out of 4. Means what, this 100 marks, if divided into 4 equal parts, he got 3, the marks equal to 3 parts. So let us divide this 100 by 4. 100, if you divide 100 into 4 equal parts, then in each part, how many marks will be there? You know, 100 divided by 4. 4 2s are 8, 10 minus 8 is 2, 20, 4 5s are 20. So when we divide 100 into 4 equal parts, each part will have 25. Okay? And out of 4 equal parts, we got 3 parts, that means 1, 2 and 3. Means 25, that is 25 threes are, we got 25 threes are 75 marks. Means he got 75 marks out of 100. He got 3/4 marks. 3/4 marks, that means what? He got 75 marks out of 100. Okay? How we found 75? Understood how we have found? Total marks are 100, so he got 3/4. Here 3 is the numerator, tells that marks he got, and 4 is denominator, shows that total marks. Total means here 4 means 4 equal parts. So total marks are divided into 4 equal parts. So when we divide 100, which is total marks, into 4 equal parts, we got 25 marks in each part. Okay, and he got 3 parts means 3 parts I have taken. So 25 threes are 75. That means he got 75 marks out of 100. And now the 75 marks, let us convert into decimal. So how to convert into decimal? 75 write as it is. Okay, 75 write as it is. And in the 100, there are 2 zeros. So where to put decimal point? Here, correct? He got 0.75 marks. Okay, understood this? Okay, so in this way, we have learned the first concept of decimals. If practice 8.1, we have solved. If you have any doubt in this, you can ask me. So thank you for today and have a nice day.